A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Dear students of class 9th, today I am going to explain some questions from your science textbook. Subject is matter in our surroundings. Sub iska topic hai textbook questions from 6 to 9. Question number 6, जो आपकी टेक्स्ट बुक में है, give two reasons to justify. A. Water at room temperature is a liquid. B. An iron almira is a solid at room temperature. You have to give the answer that why water is a liquid at room temperature and why an iron almira is a solid at room temperature. The answer is water at room temperature has a definite volume and it flows from higher level to lower level, which are the characteristics of a liquid. That is why we say that water is a liquid at room temperature. Then, iron almira is a solid at room temperature because, number one, it has a definite volume, and number two, it has a definite shape, which are the characteristics of a solid. Then, question number 7, why is ice at 273 Kelvin more effective in cooling than water at the same temperature? Ice at 273 Kelvin is more effective in cooling than water at the same temperature because it has less energy than water at the same temperature and requires latent heat of fusion for melting. Question number 8, what produces more severe burns, boiling water or steam? Steam produces more severe burns than boiling water because the molecules in steam have more kinetic energy than molecules of water. Then question number 9, name A, B, C, D and E in the following diagram showing change in its state. Here the diagram shown here represents three states of matter, solid, liquid and gas, and also the changes which take place in these states of matter. Here you see solid changes to liquid through a process denoted by A, liquid changes to gas through another process denoted by B. Here gas is converted to liquid back through a phenomena or process denoted by C, and liquid is converted to solid through another phenomenon D. Then solid is converted to gas through a phenomenon represented by E, and gas is converted to solid through a phenomenon shown by F. You have to answer these phenomena shown by A, B, C, D, E and F. Here, in these changes which take place in left to right directions, that is solid to liquid and liquid to gas and solid to gas, these phenomena are possible by increasing heat and decreasing pressure. Also, those phenomena which are denoted by arrows pointing from right to left, that is gas to liquid and liquid to solid and gas to solid. These phenomena occur due to decrease temperature or heat and increase of pressure. Now the answer of this diagram is A, the phenomena represented by A, it is called fusion, where solid changes to liquid. Then the phenomenon represented by B, that is liquid to gas, it is called vaporization. The phenomenon where gas is converted to liquid, that is called condensation. And the phenomenon where liquid is converted to solid, shown by D, it is called solidification. The phenomenon shown by E, where solid changes to gas, is called sublimation. And lastly, the phenomenon where gas is converted to D, solid, shown by F, is called sublimation. Thank you.